Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Maths DNA, from origin to infinity. Before we begin, let me tell you something. Don't practice until you get it right, but practice until you can't get it wrong. This is my sixth lecture on real analysis. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about 10 questions based on countable and uncountable sets. Before we begin, let us go through some results on countable and uncountable sets. Every subset of a countable set is countable. Finite Cartesian product of countable set is countable. For example, n cross n or z cross z cross z or n cross z all are countable. Countable union of countable sets is countable. Set of isolated points is countable. Derived set of uncountable set is uncountable. Set of all discrete intervals is countable. Set of irrational numbers is uncountable. So let us begin. First, is set of rational numbers countable or uncountable? Now let us define a function f from q to z cross n, defined as f of p by q is equals to p comma q, where p belongs to z, q belongs to n, and GCD of p comma q is 1, that is, they have only 1 as the common factor. Then f is clearly 1-1, because we get a unique image for all p by q belongs to q. We also know that z cross n is countable finite Cartesian product, and if f is a function from a to b is 1-1, and if b is countable, then a is also countable, one of the property of countable sets. Here b is equals to z cross n, which is countable, and so a is equals to q, the set of rational numbers, is also countable. Therefore the set of rational numbers is countable, and the cardinality of the set of rational numbers is alif naught. Example 2. Let s is equals to x comma y, where x square plus y square is equals to 1 by n square, where n belongs to the set of natural numbers, and either x belongs to q or y belongs to q. Here q is the set of rational numbers and n is the set of natural numbers. Then which of the following is true? This question was asked in CSIR NET 2018. The options are A. S is a finite non-empty set. B. S is countable. C. S is uncountable. And D. S is empty. Let us solve the question. Solution. Here x belongs to q or y belongs to q, which means that S belongs to q cross q. Elements are from q and q again. And we know that q is countable, and so q cross q is also countable, as it is finite Cartesian product. Therefore, option B is true. So correct answer is option B. Third, let P is equals to x minus A whole square plus y minus B whole square is equals to 1, where AB belongs to Q. P is the set of all unit circles in the complex plane with center as rational coordinates. Then which of the following question is true? This question was also asked in CSIR NET. The options are A. P is finite non-empty set. B. P is countable. C. P is uncountable. And D. P is empty. Solution. Here A belongs to Q, set of rational numbers, or B belongs to Q, set of rational numbers. It is given. Therefore, the set P belongs to Q cross Q. And we know that Q is countable, and so Q cross Q is also countable, as it is finite Cartesian product. Therefore, here also option B is true, and the correct answer is option B. Third, let S is equals to f function from n to z2, set of all the functions from n to z2, then S is countable or uncountable. Solution. We know that total number of functions from A to B is B raised to 8. Total number of elements in B raised to total number of elements in A. So the total number of functions from n to z2, that is 0, 1, is 2 raised to alif naught, which is equals to continuum, which is uncountable. Therefore, S is uncountable. Fifth, let S is equals to function f from z2 to n, set of all the functions from z2 to n. Then S is countable or uncountable. Solution. As we know that total number of functions from a to b is b raised to a. So the number of functions from z2 to n is alif naught raised to 2, that is alif naught square, which is again alif naught, which is countable as it is finite Cartesian product of countable sets. Therefore, S is countable. Sixth, let S is equals to f from R to R, set of all the functions from R to R. Then S is countable or uncountable. Solution. We know total number of functions from A to B is again B raised to A. So the total number of function from R to R is C raised to C. S of the ordinality of the real numbers is continuum, which is uncountable. Therefore, the set S is uncountable. Seventh, let S is equals to a function f from z to z, set of all the functions from integers to integers. Then S is countable or uncountable. Solution. We already know that the total number of functions from a to b is b raised to a. Therefore, the total number of functions from the set of integers to integers is alif naught raised to alif naught. Here it is infinite Cartesian product, which is equals to C, continuum, which is equals to uncountable. Therefore, S is uncountable. We need to note down that this type of questions are asked many times in CSIR. So, get a good practice of these questions. Example 8. Let X denote the 2-point set 0, 1 and write Xi is equals to 0, 1. For every I is equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Then let Y is equals to product I is equals to 1 to n Xi and Z is equals to product I is equals to 1 to infinity Xi. Then Y and Z both are countable. Y is countable and Z is uncountable. Y is uncountable and Z is countable. And option D, Y and Z both are uncountable. Solution. Here, Y is equals to a finite product I running from 1 to n Xi, which is equals to 2 raised to n. And here n is finite. So the Cartesian product is also finite. Therefore, Y is countable. And here Z is equals to product I running from 1 to infinity Xi, which is equals to 2 raised to infinity, which is infinite Cartesian product. Therefore, Z is uncountable. Therefore, option B is true and the correct answer is option B. Y is countable and Z is uncountable. 9. Which of the following subsets of R2 are uncountable? This question was asked in CSIR net. The options are A, B belongs to R2 where A is less than equals to B. Option B, A, B belongs to R2 where A plus B belongs to Q. Option C, A, B belongs to R2 if A into B belongs to Z. And option D, A, B belongs to R2 if A and B both belongs to Q. Solution. For option A, it says that A, B belongs to R2 if A is less than or equals to B. Now take A is equals to root 3 and B is equals to root 5. Then clearly A is less than or equals to B. The condition is satisfied and A belongs to the set of irrational numbers and B also belongs to the set of irrational numbers. So the given set belongs to irrationals or cross irrational, which is uncountable. Option B says that A, B belongs to R2 if A plus B belongs to Q. Now take A is equals to root 3 and B is equals to minus root 3. then a plus b is equals to 0, which belongs to q, and the given condition is satisfied. Therefore, we get a belongs to irrationals and b belongs to irrationals, and we know that set of irrational numbers is uncountable. So the given set belongs to irrationals cross irrationals, which is again uncountable. Option C, a comma b belongs to R2 if a dot b belongs to z, the set of integers. Here also we can take a is equals to root 3 and b is equals to minus root 3. Then we get a dot b is equals to minus 3, which belongs to q and z also. Therefore, the given condition is satisfied, and a belongs to irrationals and b also belongs to irrationals. So the set belongs to irrationals cross irrational, which is again uncountable. Now take option D. AB belongs to R2 if A, B belongs to Q. It is given that A and B both should be from the set of rational numbers. So the given option belongs to rationals cross rationals, which is countable. So the correct answers are option A, B and C. Example 10. The set of all the subsets of natural numbers is countable or uncountable? Now, solution. The set of all the subsets of n is the power set of n, which is equals to 2 raised to n. Here as n is infinite, so it is infinite Cartesian product, which is equals to continuum, and we know that continuum is uncountable, so it is uncountable. Thank you. Get the best material for preparation by just one click. The link is given below in the description. Check out other videos in the series over here.